The following video is a remake of an older video that has been deleted and or taken down. This video is to replace the older video and is not to be considered a new video, even if it is advertised as such, but is to be counted as how the original video was counted. Please enjoy the video. Excuse me, mate. What are you doing?
Oh, I'm just doing a ritual. A secret ritual, you see, with my friends. Where have they all gone?
Right. Shouldn't you be doing that at night?
No. Everybody knows that if you do a secret ritual at night, you get busted eventually. So I decided to do mine in broad daylight. And if I get busted because of that, well, sod it.
I see.
I know I'm wearing the wrong mask and all that. Hexy's followers wear a goat mask whilst I'm wearing a lizard one. But, yeah. Anyway. Hexy requires a sacrifice.
Who? Left Doctor Who. In the story Warrior's Gate, K-9 Mark II left with Romana to help the Thralls, I think that's what they were called, sort themselves out in East Space. This was part of John Nathan's plan to get rid of K-9, as he disliked the character, and during the season he pretty much had the character bashed about and abused in his stories. However, K-9 was very popular amongst audiences, especially children, and the Sun newspaper even had a petition to save K-9. At the same time, J&T had also plans to bring back Sarah Jane Smith and Leela to help see the Fourth Doctor transition into the Fifth Doctor, with a plan to even to have Sarah Jane join the Doctor, Adric, Tegan and Nyssa for his final story and the first two stories as the Fifth Doctor, something that Elizabeth Sladen wasn't interested in. However, when she was offered to be a co-lead in a new Doctor Who spin-off with her and K-9, she accepted, and so K-9 and Company was born. Originally titled K-9 and Sarah, K-9 and Company would have been a series of 50-minute episodes, I believe. So twice as long as a normal Doctor Who episode. 50-minute episodes of Sarah Jane and K-9 solving mysteries and fighting villains and maybe some aliens on Earth. And they would then go on investigating witchcraft, a witchcraft cult who worships the goddess Hegarty. At the same time, Sarah Jane's aunt Ward Brendan, who is hanging out with Sarah Jane and K-9, and then gets kidnapped and is then sent to be sacrificed by the gods, so Sarah Jane and K-9 have to go and rescue him. So how does K-9 and Company, a girl's best friend, hold up? Well, to me, I love it. I think it's great. I think it's a nice little piece of branched off nostalgia. However, it's gained a negative reputation on the fan base, with quite a few people not liking it. Let's start off with those negatives. Quite a lot of the earlier acts in this episode, Sarah Jane is on the phone quite a bit in the first 10 minutes. There also isn't really a huge amount of plot. I wouldn't say something that would have filled 50 minutes, but there seems to be a lot of back and forth between people's places and on the telephone, and some sort of mystery things that sort of fill the gaps. I will say it is a fast-paced story. The first 10 minutes do sort of fly, despite not being the most interesting stuff, and then the next 20 minutes really fly by, and then The final 20 minutes, they're really good. However, that and a TV mistake, which sees Sarah Jane and K-9 on the road and someone attempts to kill them by having a tractor drive down and try and kill them, but fail, is filmed at day when they should be out at night. And also a lot of focus on soil and gardening. There's quite a bit of that. And also with the soil, there's quite a lot of focus on that. But besides that, those are really the only negatives I have about it. The rest of it is quite good. Sarah Jane is a great character in this story. She continues to be great from her Doctor Who days. And she really comes into her own as the co-lead alongside K-9, once again voiced by John Leeson. And he's great. And they have a great chemistry together. And I do have some great stuff with them. I also like Brendan. I think he's a pretty good character. And he would have been another co-lead maybe in the show. I will say when we get with the villains, the Hegartys, it's difficult to tell who they are when they are unmasked, when they're unveiled the first time. I mean, you can tell on future rewatches, but it is a bit tricky. I actually had to find a post on about it once, and it told me, and I was like, oh, now I see. I did sort of suspect one of them, but I couldn't tell when I saw it, but I couldn't really tell properly. And then the other one, oh, now I see. It makes a bit more sense when you rewatch it a few times, but you're going to have to know the characters to know that. I also think there's quite a lot of obsession with the Hegarty. George Tracy is very paranoid about Hegarty. I do think the actor does a good job with that, though. I think he does well, as does the guy playing Peter Tracy. I think he does. Yeah, Peter. I think Peter's the son. If I'm wrong, then feature me will say in the edit if I got it right or if I got it got it the other way around. But I think they're good characters. Also think the Commander Pullock, he's good for the scenes he gets. And also the Bakers, they're good characters who pop in around, but their scenes aren't as highly necessary as others. It does tease that they might be involved with it in the conflict, yeah, what's going on, but that turns out to be a red herring. Fair enough, I suppose. They're pretty good characters. I wouldn't have minded seeing them back in a future story. We also see, for the first time, Aunt Lavinia, she's also a pretty good character in her few scenes. And part of the other story is Sarah Jane wondering what's happened to her, even though we already know she's going to America a few weeks early. But Sarah Jane just doesn't get the memo until the end, and she's just fussing around a lot. So I will say, on a rewatch, it is very noticeable that that's already been explained to the audience, but now something's happened. Sarah Jane thinks something's happened because she wasn't told. Although that would be part of the villain's plan, I believe. But it does make Sarah Jane play catch up with the audience a little bit. And half the mystery is gone on, certainly with rewatches. But I will say there is a good mystery here, and it has some really good stuff. And I think K-9 is handled brilliantly and has some... And it's just a great adventure. Overall, I think K-9 and Company is a fun, enjoyable sidetrack to have a look, to check out of curiosity. And is handled very well. I think it's a good story, and I would have liked to have seen more adventures with K-9 and K-9 and Sarah Jane. Sadly, despite good ratings, a new controller at BBC One, or BBC Head of Drama, whoever it was, came in and he decided not to renew the show for an actual series, meaning that A Girl's Best Friend was the one and only episode of this new spin-off. And there would not be another spin-off for another 25 years, not an official on-screen one, at least, until 2006, when Torchwood first aired. So, I mean, there were unofficial, licensed but unofficial spin-off, direct-to-video and direct-to-DVD spin-offs made by BBV and Real Time Productions. And, of course, we've got the many Big Finish audio, starting with Bernice Summerfield, and then continuing from there. Bernie Summerfield was in 1998, so technically before Doctor Who joined Big Finish. And then I think the first spin-off after Doctor Who joined was either Dalek Empire or Cyberman in the early 2000s. And then that was followed by Unit. And now, and then since then, there's been loads of spin-offs in the Doctor Who universe and spin-off Doctor Who ranges as well, such as Unbound and Exilus. So, yeah, so this kind of inspired all that. It's just a shame that it didn't really take off the ground. And until 2006, there wasn't really another proper on-screen spin-off until Torchwood aired. But at the same time, it is a nice little fun sidetrack you can check out between Logopolis and Castrovalva. And also got K-9 to pair up, well, Mark III to pair up with Sarah Jane Smith, which we then see in the Five Doctors and School Reunion. I love how they tied that in, by the way. I'm not sure which Mark model it is in Dimensions in Time. It could be any of the first three. Never mind. So, overall, K-9 and Company are Girl's Best Friends. I am going to give it a 9 out of 10. I think it's really good, really great adventure. A few issues, but mostly it's very good. I did give this a 10 because I only had the problem with the TV mistake in the original review. However, on rewatch, there are some not so interesting moments, and mainly at the start or in the first 10 to 11 minutes, and a few other not really interesting scenes throughout the story, mostly in the first half hour though. Last 20 minutes are really good though, and it does fly. So that's Girl's Best Friend. Great. And also, before we go, quickly, the titles and the theme music. The titles kind of suck a little bit. I mean, they're nicely shot and edited for the most part, but they're not really that very good as a title sequence. Just look a bit awkward. The theme, on the other hand, is really good, and I do really like the theme. I do think the end titles are right, with although it's just one still image of K-9, but considering what the opening titles are, I think that's fine. The opening titles also last a solid minute, and the end titles last about a minute and 25 seconds, roughly. So, yeah, so the story itself is actually 48 and a half minutes. 47 and a half minutes, actually. So, anyway, K-9 and Company, A Girl's Best Friend, really good, and I do recommend you check it out. Even if you end up not really being a fan of it, I do recommend you check it out, just for curiosity's sake. Anyway, that's it from me. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. Well, that was a lovely review. I do hope people will enjoy it. Hold on. Who are you? I am Hecate's servant. I have come to sacrifice you. Why? Because Hecate demands it. Are you sure? Also, why are you wearing a lizard mask? The ringleaders wore goat masks in the episode. Yes, also I chose a random mask from the shop. Right. Now I must sacrifice you! For Hecate! Daniel the Dalek?
Yes?
Well, thank you for sparing me from becoming a sacrifice.
No problem! So when are you going to do the Dalek video?
Soon.
I was hoping I and my friends could be in it.
As you said, no problem.
Yippee!
Yep. Stay tuned, folks. Next time, Daleks. The immortal enemies.
Oh. So, how exactly are we immortal?
Because of how great they are and what an impact they've made on the Doctor Who universe.
Okay.